So you've just seen the very quick unboxing of this newer 25mm f1.8 lens from Micro Four Thirds. So let's have a look at really what we get. So we get this very nice lens case or pouch. It's very nice. And as you saw in the unboxing, I've put the lens cloth in. Haven't used it yet, but I just put it in there. It seems a sensible place to have it. So this is the lens. It's very small. And as you can see, it goes from 1.8 all the way to f16. Seems all metal construction. This is a bit of a concern to me. This is the lens cap it came with. It came with an Olympus lens cap, an official Olympus lens cap by the looks of it, which makes me think that maybe someone has opened it, tried it on, put their other lens's lens cap here. This feels a bit loose, but under here we can see we've got an all metal construction. We've got very simple glass here. We've got a 49mm cap at the front because it's a 49mm thread. Here we can see the iris open nice and simply, and it's a very simple iris. I think it's got 16 blades. So the focusing dial's at the front and the aperture dial's at the back, and we've got some sort of maybe depth of field scale here. This focusing dial, the metal does seem to drag against metal, and we do get a bit of noise on the focusing dial. So that's clickless as well, which is good for video. We can focus as close as 18 centimeters all the way up to infinity. And that's it for the lens. It's fairly simple. There isn't a great deal more to say. So when we mount it on a Micro Four Thirds camera, and this is the Panasonic G7, it has a very small profile and it's very light as well. So this is a manual focus lens, so everything you do with it is completely manual. I'm going to have an aperture priority so that my shutter speed is taken care of automatically. So in conclusion, I think this is a great lens for Micro Four Thirds cameras. It's very light, it seems well built, it's very cheap, it has a 50mm equivalent focal length, and if you can get past some of the minor niggles, you'll find it's a very good lens. And those minor niggles are manual focusing. When it's mounted on the camera, there's a little bit of give and it can move ever so slightly when you're going through the focusing or changing the aperture. And of course, there's that grating noise when you change focus. So while it's probably a better suited lens to video over photography, if you're using the internal microphone, you might want to carefully think about this lens, but I would recommend it.